my little cheek cheeks this morning. This little chicken right there in the back has pasty butt, and you can see it on its booty. So I'm about to take a warm cloth and see if I can't get that off. But they're happy that I brought them some crumble feed back from Tractor Supply. My little babies. They like their warm and light. Clean his little booty up. Or her little booty. Now she's clean. They're happy with food and water. Dehydrating some strawberries and some bananas we had in the refrigerator. Our strawberries were in the refrigerator. But if we leave them in there too much longer, they're going to go bad. So I'm chopping them up and dehydrating, or actually slicing them and putting them in the dehydrator, and some bananas, doing the same thing to them. They'll be nice and sweet. It'll be kind of like candy texture and flavor. Dehydrating pulls the sugars out, so it really makes them super sweet, much sweeter than they were as fresh fruit. So that's what we're starting our morning out. Where are you going to go? I don't mind you being in my videos. And I'll check this dehydrator throughout the day and pull out any pieces that seem dry quicker than the others. How awkward is it to always have a camera in your face?
It makes me want to smile. All the time.
Pour it all in one spot.
Thank you. I'm going to, I got something put up with that one, so that's it.
So we got this one row finished, weeded, ready to plant in. I just got to add some compost to the top of it. Next, I'm going to work on the little echinacea area, clear that out, make it look more like a little bed, a little flower bed. And Robert is working on mulching all the rows. We're run out of boxes again. So he's going to mulch what he can with what boxes we have left. Just kind of showing y'all what we're doing today. Got that echinacea bed cleaned out. Maybe that lavender will have a chance to grow now. Got that done. The sunflowers are popping up in this little sunflower bed. We ran out of boxes, so we still couldn't do this little walkway. Massive comfrey. Potatoes have not come out. Hadn't sprouted out of the ground yet. I'm wondering if we've gotten too much rain and they rotted down in the ground, but I'm not sure. We'll see. Those big old alums. Allium, however you want to say it. Nice and big. Green onions, basically. And this asparagus has gone to seed. Are going to seed. Those garlics over there are doing good. All of our lettuces are still doing good. The cauliflower's doing good. The carrot's still struggling because I hadn't reseeded this carrot bed yet. A cilantro, parsley, dill, more parsley. They're all doing good. These cabbages are doing fantastic. Got some spinach there. Over there. Some Brussels sprouts. Another cabbage. Some more spinach. My peas are sprouting up. These lettuces are doing good. My grape plant back there. My server, he might get a tip. Today, Robert got this added walkway area. You can see where the new wood chips have been laid. But he added all that walkway area. Added all of this walkway area. And I finished weeding all the way down there to the very end. But we're out of boxes again. So, more boxes. More boxes. But it's looking nice. Every time we come out here, it's my pizza. So I'm gonna go eat. Thing about this is starting a garden from scratch is that every year it does look better. It makes you feel better every year when you look back at your progress. When I look back at our first garden here, they had that old garden and we had to burn those rows down, but it was like way over here and it was two rows all the way down here and,
yeah.
And restarted them. And I've had a nice garden here one year.
Yeah.
But this is so much nicer than any garden that we've had.
Yeah.
And it just shows that we've improved over time.